The Biden administration will extend the nationwide mask requirement for public transit. That mandate will now run through May the 3rd. The order was set to expire April 18th, but the CDC recommended extending it as officials monitor a rise in COVID cases in parts of the country, particularly the Northeast. The Biden administration had hoped to roll out a more flexible masking strategy that would have replaced that nationwide requirement. Meantime, the state of Indiana and Attorney General Todd Rokita joining a 21-state lawsuit against this mandate. Rokita claims that it's an overreach of the CDC's authority. Well, Friday marked 1 year since these eight people were killed at the FedEx ground facility in Indianapolis. We spoke with Congressman André Carson about that tragedy this past week.
And saying that we are one community, we're one nation, and we have to do a better job in terms of fighting back against gun violence and dealing with mental health in a very honest and open way.
We also spoke this week with State Senator Aaron Freeman about the state's red flag gun laws, which many have pointed to after the FedEx shooting, and asked why more wasn't done to keep guns away from the suspected shooter in this case.
I think the law is pretty fair. It's pretty balanced and works when properly applied and when pursued.
A lot of discussion, of course, about whether that law could have been more fully utilized at the local level in this particular case. Meantime, Senator Todd Young met with students in the Jewish community at IU Bloomington this week. The rabbi there says there have been more anti-Semitic incidents this year than she's seen in more than 30 years at the university.
We can't be desensitized to these sorts of acts and statements that are hateful.
Jewish Hoosier community.
Senator Young signed a banner that says, "I stand against anti-Semitism. Stop the hate." And stick around. We're back to wrap things up with this week's winners and losers straight ahead.